multiplication and addition together again in the distributive property. But does this work with subtraction too? Let's check that out. If I start off with something like A times B minus C, well, the distributive property doesn't tell me anything about subtraction. It just tells me about addition. But subtraction is the addition of a negation. I can turn my subtraction into an addition. I can write this as A times B plus the negation of C. So now over here I have an addition. I have a sum, so I can use the distributive property. I can use the distributive property to expand this as A times B plus the product of A and the negation of C. So A times B, well, that's just A times B. A times the negation of C is the negation of AC. And of course, if we're adding a negation, that's just subtraction. That's what subtraction is. So that gives us AB minus AC. And sure enough, multiplication distributes over subtraction just like it distributes over addition. A times the whole quantity B minus C is A times B minus A times C. Now, of course, because multiplication is commutative, we can switch the order of these. I can write this as B minus C times A, and that equals, well, I can reverse the order of each of these. B times A minus C times A. So I can have the subtraction on the left or on the right, and I can use the distributive property to expand, to multiply it out. We call it expanding when we go this way. When we come back this way, we call it factoring. We factor out an A to write this difference as this product. Now let's put this to work on a couple of problems. Oh, that looks like a lot of work. We didn't come here to do a lot of work. We came here to do a little bit of work. Well, at least no more work than we have to. I hear you, right? You're willing to work, but you don't want to have to do work that you don't have to do. So we don't want to multiply this out. 79 times 13, that's a drag. 59 times 13, that's a drag too. 13's in both of them. We can use the distributive property. We can factor out the 13. We can take out that 13 and write this as 79 minus 59 times 13. And all we're doing there is using the distributive property. We're factoring out the 13. 79 minus 59, well, that's 20. So our problem is now 20 times 13, and that is easy. That's 260. And we're done with that, ready to go to the next problem. Oh! Who thinks of these things? This is ridiculous. This will take all day. I mean, it's not like how... Well, we're doing a distributive property lesson, right? So we're going to... Oh, I don't have anything to distribute. Multiplying by this ridiculous number is hard. That number's close to a million. I can multiply by a million all day long, just throw on some extra zeros. But this isn't a million. This is close to a million. It's only two away from a million. Well, I'm going to write this down in terms of something, well, at least I know how to deal with a million. So I'm going to write, it's a million minus two times the 335. Ah! Distributive property again. I can expand this to a million, all those zeros, times 335, minus 2 times 335. These products are easy. They're way easier than that. This is a lot less work. We like a lot less work. So we multiply these, multiplying by a million. That's easy. We just throw on a bunch of extra zeros. That's 335 million. And we're going to subtract from that 2 times 335. That's 670. 2 times 300 is 600. 2 times 35 is 70. So we're going to have to subtract from this huge number. We're going to subtract 670. That's pretty simple. We can just, it's going to be a list. We start off with 335 million. We subtract a pretty small number. We're going to get something that's a little bit less than 335 million. 99. And back here we're going to have 330. And we want to check this real quick. We add it back up, 0 and 0, 0, 3 and 7, that's 10, 0, carry the 1, 3 and 6 is 0, and then we keep carrying the 1s, get 9, 9, and it all adds up. And there's our answer, 334,999,330, and we are